Hello everybody! Today's video is the week 2 litter update for these medium Labradoodle puppies. Hi, I'm Claire from Van Isle Labradoodles, and today's video we are going to go through each of these medium Australian Labradoodle puppies from our 3 seasons litter at Van Isle Labradoodles. We're going to give you a little bit of information about each of the puppies, what they've been up to over the past week, and we're going to give you a little bit of information about Mama Labradoodle Spirit as well. So we'll start with Speespee, our beautiful Mama Labradoodle. This is Spirit's retirement litter, and I think that she probably feels that she's ready for retirement. She has had 4 litters, and all of her litters are always beautiful Labradoodle puppies. She is one of our experienced moms, obviously, and she does just a fabulous job raising her puppies. She's very caring, she's very gentle, and she takes excellent care of them. And you can see they're all spotless. Everybody has got just gorgeous gleaming coats and just doing fabulously. Now, one of the reasons these little Labradoodle puppies have such beautiful coats and such shine, you can really see the shine on the video from the Ebony puppies. Their coats are so glossy. The other puppies are also super shiny. It just shows up better on the video on the blacks. And part of the reason why these puppies have such beautiful gleaming coats and why they all have such large tummies is the nutrition that Spirit has. So we feed all of our Labradoodles a 100% raw food diet, and we make sure that that diet is well balanced. So Spirit is currently eating about 3 pounds of raw food a day, which is quite a bit more than what she would normally eat. Normally, adult dogs, if they're not working, which includes having babies, eat about 2% of their body weight. So Spirit's 44 pounds after she has these puppies and we have her spayed, then we will keep her closer to about 40, 42 pounds. We let our Labradoodle mamas carry a little bit of extra weight when they're working, having puppies, just so they have plenty of reserves for looking after their big broods. So we'll cut her back a bit once she's weaned her puppies. But for now, she's at 3 pounds a day, and as these puppies get bigger, she'll eat more. So when these little Labradoodles are at their peak demand on Mama Spirit, which will be between week 3 and 4 and through to about week 4 and a half, then she'll probably be up to eating 5 pounds of raw food a day. And then we also give her every day, along with all of our Labradoodles, a really nice pre-probiotic product that's a live pre-probiotic. And it's a canine-specific one, and it's from Oli Naturals. It's a really nice product, and it really does seem to work very well for both the puppies and the moms. And we also give her a vitamin B supplement, and we give her a calcium supplement. And she also eats bones. Now, Spirit is not a big fan of raw bones, so we have to look for more innovative ways to make sure that she's getting her calcium that she needs. And it's not just calcium. You can't just give her calcium and just plain calcium, as then her body is not able to absorb it and utilize it properly. It has to all be balanced with the other minerals in the product. So she needs phosphorus, vitamin D, vitamin K, magnesium, and so forth. And that's what allows the calcium to actually function properly. So again, we use a product that is canine specific, and that way we don't have to worry about eclampsia. And also, all of this goes through Mama's milk, so that's why all of these little Labradoodle puppies benefit from what Spirit's eating. So they are growing really well, have beautiful skeletal development, because they're getting all the calcium they need. Because of course they're growing like mad, as we'll see as soon as we start doing their weights. You'll be amazed at how much weight these puppies have gained in just 2 weeks. And of course you can see how much larger they are since they were born too. They're all really coming along. So as a whole, for the past week, what the litter has been up to as a group is mostly eating, sleeping, and growing. And my goodness, they are growing. They're all quite mobile now. They're not up on all fours with a lot of stability, but they are able to move around really quite readily. And we will also see with some of them today that their eyes have opened. Now we're filming this video today on Thursday. The puppies are not actually 2 weeks old until Friday, Saturday, because they were born over 2 days. So we are a couple days ahead of their 2 week birthday, but our schedule just doesn't allow for us to film it and get it out to you on YouTube in time. So we thought we'd better do it early rather than have you wait for extra days. So now let's go through each of these little Labradoodle puppies and tell you about them. We're going to do them in birth order as we always do. And the first puppy born in this litter is Black Collar Girl, who's right here. How handy. Come here, sweetie pie. Now Spirit was just outside having her morning run and checking everything out. So the puppies have all been fed, so it's a really great time for the video. Hello, sweetheart. So this is little Black Collar Girl, and she does have some slits there for her eyes, but they're not entirely open yet. I'm sure they will be by the time she is actually 2 weeks old, which will be tomorrow late in the day. So I believe she was born around 10:30 at night. So she's just getting ready for that actual 2 week magic time. And this little girl is a beautiful golden caramel color, and you can see the beautiful shine on her coat. She's such a pretty color of caramel. Really like this shade. She looks a lot like her grandma Bijou. This is the same color Bijou was. And then she's got these pretty little dip toes here, and she has, you gonna show me underneath there, some white on her chest as well. Very pretty little puppy. This little puppy is in the middle of the pack. She's not extraordinary in any way yet. She's not talkative, she's not quiet, she's just right there in the middle, just doing a great job. And she weighs 842 grams. So really closing in on that 1 kilogram mark already at just before 2 weeks of age. And you can see that also she's very calm. She's used to us doing all sorts of things with her, such as going upside down. You'll see how I can do nothing and she's totally relaxed. And she can let me play with her little feet and have a great time. And actually, now that I've turned her upside down, you can see she's showing you right there. She has black pads. So if she's going to have black pads, then she's going to have a black nose eventually. And that means she'll be an apricot, not a caramel. So we'll just wait for that to develop and go through that a bit more. And you can hear our other dogs barking in the distance there. They're all just outside of Spirit's maternity ward here. The doors are all glass, so they can see in what's happening. And it's also right near our front door. And we do get a lot of delivery, so maybe somebody's delivering while we're doing our video. Next is the giant of the litter, and that is Orange Collar Girl. Oh, this little girl. This is our big personality. She's the great big dog. She's the great big personality, and her eyes are open. She may not show them to you right now. Oh, there we go. She gave you a little tiny glimpse of them, but they have opened up. They actually opened up yesterday. So this doesn't surprise me because this little girl likes to be front and center of everything. This is one outgoing puppy, and my goodness, does she have a voice. There has only been one time when a puppy has been what we call lost, which means they're away from the rest of the group and can't find their way back. They're too far away in the nest to be able to locate the right way to go to find mom and their siblings, and that was Orange Collar Girl. And I think you probably could have heard her all the ways in Victoria from Duncan, because my goodness, she can squawk. She used to talk a lot if she was very unhappy, if she didn't get the spot she liked at the milk bar, and she still chatters around about that. So she happens to be at a position where the milk has run out, she will start giving you some quite a lot of complaining and telling Spirit that, excuse me, things are not the way I want them to be. So this little lady, you can see already her black nose is filling in, and she is going to be, or she is, an apricot tuxedo. And a tuxedo is where we have all these beautiful white markings. Tuxedo is part of the Irish spotting pattern, and that's what in Labradoodles we call it tuxedo. So she has lots of white around her face, up her head, and then all of the white down around her neck to give her that beautiful white ruff. White on her legs, front and back, and then lots of white on her chest and stomach. So it looks like she's wearing a tuxedo. Now, when she was first born, I thought maybe this tuxedo would vanish and we wouldn't see it because her coloring at that point, I didn't know if she was caramel or apricot. I thought it might lighten, but as you can see, it's actually darkened since she was born. And especially around her head, you can see that it's dark. And on the back of her ears here, it's even darker. So she's just a really beautiful puppy, and I'm pretty sure she knows that because she is quite a character. And she is 950 grams. So at 2 weeks, she is just shy of a kilogram. So she is already 2 pounds, which is a very nice weight for a 2-week-old puppy. Yes, it is. Normally, she's never this quiet. Oh, and she also is very used to going upside down and being quite comfortable with that, not minding, quite comfortable with having her feet handled. Now, the puppies are 2 weeks, and so we will be clipping their claws for the first time right after this video. They're getting a little bit sharp, and that is not comfortable if you're a spirit. So there is our big girl, which I'll just put back over here so she has a good spot there. There we go, sweetheart, good girl. Next is Pink Collar Girl, and Pink is the first of the two ebony puppies. Now, this is my favorite color. I absolutely adore black dogs. When Labradoodles were first starting to be bred and made their way into Canada around the 2004-2005 time period, they were pretty much all black. There was no parties. You didn't get the white flash. Oh, Bisbee, she's had enough. You didn't get the white flash on the face. You just got solid puppies, and black was mostly what you got. And I can remember the first time I had a chocolate puppy. I was just so excited that I had a puppy that wasn't black or cream and had an actual chocolate. Now it's really hard to find the black ones. They're few and far between because we all tried so hard to have different colors. So when we have blacks, I get very excited. So this little beauty queen, she is a black with white flash. And flash is what we refer to these white markings as. You can also call them miss marks, and you can call them abstract markings. Now, because she's black, she will have a black nose. All black dogs have black noses. It's the creams, the caramels, and the red shades that have different colored noses. And they can be either black or they can be brown, rose colored. All brown dogs have brown noses. All black dogs have black noses, and if they have black noses, they also have black lips, black pads, and black eye rims. So little Miss Pink Collar Girl is up to 762 grams. This is one of the sweeties in the litter. She's a very gentle kind of puppy. She allows the other puppies to push her out of the way. She doesn't argue for a spot or anything. She holds her own, but she's also one that'll just say, well, I'd rather you just did what you wanted rather than fight you. And her eyes are slitted, but they're not completely open yet, similar to black collar girls. Now, you see occasionally she's starting like that. There you go. So you can see her moving. So lots of times people think that's because puppies are dreaming. But really what that is a completely designed by nature thing so that even when the puppies are sleeping, because at this age they do spend most of their time sleeping, they are sleeping for probably 22 hours a day. What that is they are always flexing their muscles. They're using their muscles. You can see how she's moving. They're doing all sorts of things with their body. So even though they're sleeping, they're getting some exercise and their muscles are becoming more toned and developed. It's a really clever system. So here she goes upside down and you can see she is a very relaxed puppy. This is one of the most accommodating and accepting puppies in the litter. And she has lots of white on her chest, pretty, pretty white feet. And then she's got this lovely white markings under her chin and on her face. So she is close to a tuxedo in terms of her markings, but we just call her a posh suit because she doesn't quite make the grade as a tuxedo. I think she's beautiful and she's just the sweetest little thing. Right, Miss Pinky? Yeah. So we'll put her back there. There we go, Pinky. And after Pink, we have Yellow Collar, who is the other black puppy. And this is our first boy in the litter. Hey, buddy. Come on. And again, you can see all of that shine in this beautiful ebony coat. Now, his pattern is a little different. And his eyes are actually open. Oh, there, he just flashed them to you. You may not be able to see them. They're harder to see as well because he has the black around his eyes, but his eyes are open. They opened late last night, just when I was coming in for the last time before going to bed. I saw that they were open. So this little guy's pattern is phantom. And phantom is the term that we use when they have these beautiful points, the tan points. And you can see he's got the tan points over his eyebrows, on his face, on his legs, and then he has just a little smidge of white here. And he's got dip toes, and he's got that same color on his hind legs, and then also in his vent area, which is under his tail. So this is a really handsome, beautiful puppy. He's just gonna be really stunning and really stand out in the crowd when he gets a little older. And then the fun little thing that he has is his little goatee, and he has just a little teensy little smidge of white up there on his mouth. That won't be very visible by the time he grows up, but it's very cute to look at for now. Yellow color is very similar to pink. He's very easygoing, he's very gentle. He doesn't push his way into anything. He and Pink are often found together. They're very good friends. And Mr. Yellow is 799 grams. So they're very close in size. They're very similar in many different ways, not just their base color. And you'll see he's snuggled up to my neck here, so all the puppies know who I am. They can't hear me, of course, because their ears won't be open until maybe next week, the week after. But they are used to my scent now because I always hold them up close to my neck so that we're always doing some scenting work that way. And I'm always talking so they can feel the vibration in my chest. So when they do open their ears and sound is what they can hear, it won't be just quite so startling to them because they're used to having this vibration that they feel. It means nothing to them, but it does get them used to all sorts of different things. And it's one of the things we do as part of desensitization because once, even though their ears aren't open and they can't hear anything, they are able to sense vibration on the floor. So we do several things so that there is vibration on the floor. So if the washing machine is on, the vacuum is on, things like that, they can feel those vibrations going on. Next is Green Collar. Green Collar is the smallest puppy in the litter, and he's hiding over here. And my goodness, this guy, he has done just fabulously in his development. So for the first day, I helped him out so that he always got a good spot at the milk bar. And that was all he really needed. He just didn't really need my help after that. I gave it to him for a few more days, but he really was quite fine on his own. And his eyes are open. So you can see it has nothing really to do with the size of the puppy as to whether or not they are meeting these milestones. It's just each individual puppy. So his eyes were actually open 2 days ago. So he's been looking around for quite a while. Now he's very similar to Orange Collar in terms of being marked like a tuxedo. However, he's going to be a dead ringer for his mama spirit because you can see that the color on his back is very light. It's not as dark and prominent as Orange Collar is. So Spirit, when she was a puppy, looked just like Green Collar. And now when you look at Spirit, obviously she looks like she's all cream. The only time when we see this apricot color on her back is when she's just been groomed. And then you can see very distinctly that she has that on her back. Otherwise, all we see is the apricot on her ears. Otherwise, she looks like she is a cream girl. And she's cream because she has a black nose. She's not chalk and she's not white. This little sweetheart has already one little tiny spot of color coming in on his pink nose, and it is black. So I'm going to guess that, and he has one little black spot on his lips there. So he is going to really be completely identical to Spirit. So we know he's going to be one heck of a gorgeous puppy. Spirit is absolutely beautiful. And if he has her pretty face, oh, he's just going to be a real gorgeous little guy. This little fellow, he is a go-getter. He is feisty. He fights for his position at the milk bar. He has fought to gain the weight that he's gained, and he is tough as nails. And Mr. Green Collar is now 641 grams. So I couldn't be more proud of him. That's a really good accomplishment, and he has worked hard to get there, believe me. Right, buddy? Yeah, oh, that's a good boy. And he also was very used to being handled because initially I handled him far more than anyone else because he was little and I wanted to make sure he was getting everything he needs. So you see that they'll all do this. They all drop their paws. They are all completely relaxed, completely trusting, happy to be here, not worried if I touch their feet. As you can see, he's gonna fall right off to sleep there with his head going off to the side. So that's something we work really hard at doing. So I'm usually in here about 4 or 5 times a day. I only am in here for maybe 10 minutes, sometimes 20, just to handle each one of them so that they're very used to being handled. And you can see he doesn't even move when I put him down. And that's really what I like to see, is that level of trust. And then you saw him just do a twitch, and that's that muscle movement that I'm talking about. And last but not least in the litter is Blue Collar. Where are you, Blue? Here you are. No, that's Black. Black and Blue look very similar. Come here, sweetheart. There we go. And Blue is our last little girl, and she's going to be an Apricot as well. Now, this is the squirmy puppy in the group. She is the one that I spend the most time hanging on to, moving around, doing things with, because as you can see her right now, as soon as I pick her up, she's always darting about and looking for something and wondering what's going to happen. So I spend a lot of time with her, just handling her, picking her up, putting her down. Quite often I'll pick her up like this. I'll put her back down. I'll just wait for like 5 seconds, just like that. And you can see she's quite moving around quite a bit. And then I'll pick her back up again. And I'll just keep doing that over and over and over until she finally gets bored of the whole process and she settles down, which is what my goal is. So Miss Blue, her eyes are wide open. They opened up last night as well. She can't really see anything. All the puppies whose eyes are open, all they can see is big blobs. They can't distinguish any shapes yet. They would still, if they were moving around, they wouldn't be able to ascertain that this was, say, the end of the whelping box. They would walk into it still. They walk into me quite often when I'm in here. And if you just caught her yawn there, she has really, really big, strong black lips. Her black nose is all filled in already, and there she is looking at the camera. Oh, perhaps you're going to be a bit of a diva. I don't know. She's such a good little girl. And she has some really pretty little white markings. So again, some flash up on her head here, a little bit of white up the nose. She's got the dipped paws all the way around. She has the dipped paws and the cute little white tip on the tail. And then underneath we have some white on the chest as well. So she's a very pretty little puppy. And if we do her upside down, she'll be fine, but she will be the one who fusses the most. And really, that's all she does. So it's nothing that's serious. It's just out of everybody, she's the one who moves around the most. And she doesn't mind having her feet touched. So hello, hello, hi. So now when I go in to approach them with my face, I'm a little bit more aware of what I'm doing, so I don't have my face going right in theirs, because now they can see a blob coming out them. And I'm sure having a great big blob must be a little bit disconcerting when you've just all of a sudden opened your eyes and didn't even know there was anything out in the world that was all just safe and black until now. And Blue is 758 kilograms, or not kilograms, that would be too big, grams. So pretty much everyone's probably going to be either over or at that 1 kilogram mark, I'm thinking, next week. Green probably won't be, and Blue may not be, but we're going to all be closing in really fast on that kilogram mark. So that's all the puppies for this week. I hope you enjoyed the video. They're a really nice litter. They're very, very quiet other than their spokesperson, Orange Collar, here. Otherwise, we really don't hear anything from them at all. Spirit's happy. Spirit's out of the nest quite a bit, like she is right now. She left. She often is sleeping either just in front of the whelping box, or she has her donut bed beside the whelping box that she also goes into. She does take all of her meals in the whelping box still. She will not eat outside of the whelping box, and I am still feeding her by hand. She's not quite ready yet to eat on her own, but she's going out. She's enjoying lots of fun times running around and patrolling controlling the property because that is Spirit's job. She is the boss in the house and she takes her job of patrolling the grounds and making sure nothing's amiss very seriously. So she does that 3 or 4 times a day. And she's out and about and interacting with us. She's in the house with us. And then she can open the door to come back in here on her own. And when she does, we can hear her do that so we can come and close it behind her so none of the other dogs can come in and disturb the puppies. So we will see you again next week, and we may have some puppies whose ears are open. Definitely everybody's eyes will be open. And if you have any questions or comments, please go ahead and write them below. In order to comment on a YouTube video, you need to go down to the bottom of the page under the video, and there will be something there that says create your own channel. Create your own channel is just YouTube talk for create your own account. You can call yourself anything you want. So if you don't want people to know that you're Jane Doe, you can call yourself Doodle Lover or whatever you want to call yourself. Then you can see all the comments. You can make your comments as well. And we love hearing from you. So we hope you do that. And we hope you're subscribed to the channel as well so that you get all of our videos and learn all about Labradoodles and how fabulous they all are. Thanks so much for watching.